Okay, so we've already talked about one way to visualize a mass bobbing on a spring. Let me draw that picture over here. Okay, so we're thinking about this mass going up from x max to minus x max. And we've talked about this interpretation over here, but this was a graph of position versus velocity. What if I want to know position versus time? Well, at time equals 0, our mass started up here at x max. Remember, the period was 2 seconds. So after 2 seconds, well, one cycle, one period, means that the mass has returned to its original starting point. What happened after 1 second, halfway between these two? Well, after 1 second, our object was way down here, all the way at negative x max. After 0.5 seconds, the object passes through equilibrium, so we're going to draw its position on this zero line. And same with after 1.5 seconds. It turns out that if you fill in more and more parts of this graph, more and more dots, you'll see a shape start to emerge. And you can fill in those dots using the math we learned just in the previous video. This is a graph of position versus time, which we call x of t. And this is a wonderful equation. It says that we have some maximum, let's call this amplitude, that's modified by this function, sine of omega t plus pi over 2. And this is just some function that, whenever I plug in a t, it gives me a number between negative 1 and 1. And it repeats forever. Now I'm going to draw some potential graphs for the velocity as a function of time. And I want you to tell me which one is the best. So, I've drawn you some graphs. No, it's not just a bunch of pretty pictures, though I agree they are very beautiful. So this may look confusing, but the way to read this graph is to look one color at a time. So we know that the blue graph depicts position versus time. And what we want now is velocity versus time. And there's four candidates. Well, there's the blue graph. Maybe you think it has the exact same graph as position. There's the green, and the pink, and the red. Now I want you to look through these and think which makes sense. And the best thing to do will be to look at this diagram and think, okay, if our motion is starting up here and progressing around this phase diagram, which of these graphs best makes sense for the velocity as a function of time? And think, does the particle start with velocity, or does it start with positive, negative, zero velocity? When is the velocity negative? When is it positive? Everything you can learn from this, you should be able to see reflected in this graph somehow. So go ahead, take a stab at it. This is a tricky question.